You punching?
I'm not punching. I'm tapping my belt.
Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, two camera shot. And we have, for the first time on Superstar Save Point, the Prince of Phenomenal. AJ Styles.
Prince of Phenomenal.
Yes. We're playing. You can tell them what game we're playing.
Well, let me tell you the backstory between Bill Laimbeer's combat basketball.
Yes.
Most probably don't know who Bill Laimbeer is.
No.
He played for the Pistons.
Is this him?
This is him. He was a basketball player for the Pistons, Detroit Pistons. He got in a lot of fights.
Okay.
So that's the only reason why I know him. I didn't know if he's a good player or not. I just know he didn't back down from anybody.
Okay.
So I guess in that, they said, hey, why not for some of the first games ever made for the Super Nintendo, we make Bill Laimbeer's combat basketball.
Because he's a fighter.
Yes. And I say this because I got my Super Nintendo for Christmas. I beat Mario game like that night.
Yeah.
So I was jonesing.
Oh, so like you opened it and beat Mario.
That night. Yeah. By that night I beat it. So I was like, I need something.
Yeah.
And so back then we rented games.
Yeah. From Blockbuster.
There was a place called Curtis Mathis in Gainesville, Georgia that I used to rent from. Yeah, okay. It's really old. Doesn't even exist anymore. Fact of the matter is, they had this game.
Yeah.
Bill Laimbeer's combat basketball, and I was so excited.
Okay. All right, so let's play Bill Laimbeer's combat basketball.
Let's go.
So, this is the second
I got
game
a weird golf cart. Brings out the ball.
Uh-oh, okay. I'm red. AJ's, or Prince of Phenomenal is blue.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, that was
a pass.
Out. My ball. My ball.
Oh, come on. What are you going to do? Oh, well, how did you get so fast?
I don't know.
I'm coming for you, though.
Nope.
Big dive.
Ah, Jesus. Oh, no. Oh, that was a bomb. No. Okay, oh, the ball.
Yeah.
Shoot. Come on. Rebound. Give me. No. Don't pass to him. Give me. Ball's in the air.
Oh, no. I passed it. Get out of here.
Come on.
Come on. No.
Game is so weird.
Hard to pass.
Three. That's in.
Dang, it's not. It wasn't even close. Come here. I feel like I gotta do a little tech mo.
Okay, AJ, so what people might not know, so they know you play games. You've explained that through your social medias and whatnot, interviews and things, but they don't know how much of a historian that you are.
Dang.
So can you give us a little bit of knowledge on your history with video games?
Well, I mean, at a young age, my parents had got me addicted to Mario because they bought me a system. So I've played everything. I mean, anything I can get my hands on, I played as a kid, just like you did probably.
Uh-huh.
Some hold up, you know, more special place in my heart depending on how I guide them.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't care about Super Mario Brothers 2. I do. Oh, God.
Ooh.
But I thought it was a great game in the way that they did it. I thought was spectacular.
Yeah. So you know the stuff with that game, like from what I understand.
Yes.
Okay. So
it was made from another game.
Yeah.
I forget the name of the Japanese game.
An alien game?
No. It wasn't. It was literally the same game, except they switched to Mario characters. I thought it was brilliant the way they did it because you know Mario was dreaming. This wasn't real. That's why a lot of the characters don't make sense.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Half time.
Ball's in the air.
Two to four.
The ball's in the air.
Two to four. They don't get its feature. They can turn off the gravity and just bring it back.
Oh, shoot, I forgot about that.
Okay, so you also have like a sweet game room at your house too.
Yeah, I think it's pretty sweet. I have about five arcade games.
Stand-ups.
Yeah, stand-ups. I enjoy pinball, but they're a little expensive.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just a more of a computer kind of guy, you know, like the monitors and whatnot.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Oh, no.
That's in there.
Come on.
6-4.
Is this the comeback? Oh, there we go. See, getting the ball down court. There we go. God. I'm waiting.
Where are my guys at?
Waiting in the wings.
Oh, no.
Here we go.
Get it.
Whoa. Oh, come on. Out of there. No.
Look at that.
Everybody's just diving across. I feel like I'm playing like Mutant League basketball.
Am I going for a dunk?
No dunks.
Oh, nice. What the heck?
Nice.
I got to remember the directional pad. I don't think many people know that arcade machines aren't as expensive as they once used to be. Oh, come on.
Oh, yeah, especially because you can like build your own.
Yeah. You can get on YouTube and figure out how to build your own. It's really cool to have in your house. I mean, everybody's, I don't know if you remember the show Silver Spoons. But it was a rich kid back in the day, and And he had a bunch of cool stuff, and I thought to myself, that would be the coolest thing, to have an arcade machine in your house.
It's like the Macaulay Culkin in yes. Home Alone, when he thinks that pizza in a limousine is like the height of luxury.
Yes. No, get out of here.
No. Oh, nice. There we go.
Oh, dude, I'm fighting with a dude.
Dang it, get up. No.
Juke.
No.
Oh, dang yes. it. Oh.
Nice. Out of here.
This is very intense.
Uh-oh.
Get in there!
Two points!
Oh, dang it.
God!
Oh, God!
Pass it! Pass the ball!
Dang it. Not a three.
Come on. This is too much. Oh. Nice. Oh, come on. No. Oh, backcourt. Come on.
3 seconds.
Come on. This game got real intense real fast.
Oh, get a three. Get a three on him.
Don't. Oh. Okay. Halftime.
Time up. Come on. Is that game?
I don't remember. Dang it.
You know, as a kid, I didn't think it was that fun, but then again, yeah. I didn't have anybody to play with.
Yeah.
So.
It started out weird, but.
It's actually kind of fun.
Yeah, then it got intense. I feel like you need to play Kofi, because Kofi's played the game.
But. Heck, I couldn't remember how to play. You think he remembers how to play it?
I know, he sounded pretty into it. Would you want to play him?
Sure.
Kof, I'm bringing in the ringer.
I didn't say I was good at this.
Mr. 24/7.
Hey,
ringer baby.
Play it again, same thing, right?
Play it again, Sam.
Yeah. Okay. But Prince of Phenomenal, we gotta get more information on you. What's your favorite game of all time?
Of all time, I think to say what your favorite game is impossible, right? Isn't it?
Ooh!
Basket! 2 points!
Okay, favorite game on Super Nintendo?
Shoot, Street Fighter 2.
Ooh, good choice. Okay. Then who's your favorite character in the game?
Ken.
Ooh, nice. You're a Ken guy, okay. Are you any good currently still?
Once they went to, like, the remix part,
mm-hmm.
I dropped it.
But you're still good at Street Fighter 2.
Yes, I think so. Oh my god, jeez, who's shooting? Bill Laimbeer? Oh, come on!
Nice, get him, Kofi.
This is combat basketball.
Bring in the ringer.
Screw it.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Three-pointer.
Ooh.
Count it!
Oh. The jumping in animation is so weird.
Stupid.
It's true to life. It's a bird's eye view, guys. This was like hot when it first came out.
When it first came out, it was a pretty big deal, right?
Yeah.
Gosh, I'm getting schooled here.
Did you play this like earlier today?
My God!
That was a three,
bro! That was a three!
What's your history with this game?
I used to rent this all the time, man. Like, I don't know. I just enjoyed it.
All basketball players have to have mohawks. Yeah. Have to be white and wear red or blue.
I can tell you this, for the Super Nintendo, I was shocked as a kid to see how great Street Fighter 2 looked. Like looked like exactly like the arcade game.
Yeah.
But once you get a Switch, they got Street Fighter 2 on there.
So my son says today, he's like, Dad, do you even know what a Switch is? He's 7.
Wow.
I'm like, I know more about video games than you.
And your kids are into sports and video games.
Yeah.
Like both. That's what we're trying to breed, you know. Good athletes, good gamers, so all around solid human beings. Yeah. Now, are there any, like, many gaming spots in Gainesville, Georgia? Ooh!
Not so much anymore. Yeah, they're kind of obsolete in a way, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's such a lost art, isn't it?
Like, it sure is, dude. I wish they had, like, just arcade machines.
Yeah.
Yeah. And just, like, the whole experience of, like, going to an arcade and
kids will never know what that like.
Talking face to face.
Stand around watching a guy play, maybe beat a record or something, you know? That's cool.
The best thing to me used to be going in and playing a fighting game, putting your quarter up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then when people would try to steal your quarter, so you'd like put your ID up. You have one, like, no, this is definitely me. Next.
Oh man, I don't have any players down there.
Ooh. So they might not matter.
33 seconds.
He might catch.
Moves like that. Right?
Don't go out of it. Oh shit!
On the edge.
Good shot!
No. It's a terrible shot.
All right, not a good shot.
I kind of now, after playing this with you guys, I want like a remake of this game.
Could you imagine though? It'd probably be pretty freaking awesome.
Really good.
Come on.
Nope.
I just got a Chinese star thrown at me.
I thought that was trash that was just randomly on the court.
Oh man, is it power-ups?
I don't know if you guys played Atari,
Yeah.
The first game I ever flipped. Not literally flipped, but like...
Oh, I was going to say.
everybody knows I don't like losing, but... Oh, man.
Yeah, especially after yesterday.
Oh! The buzzer beater! The buzzer beater!
I can't even... What's my guy doing standing out of bounds? That's game, isn't it?
12-4. Okay, so first game you ever flipped.
First game I ever flipped, Asteroids for the Atari.
Damn.
Yeah, man. That was a big deal to me because, you know...
Can you explain flipped?
You know, 900,900, you know, all that, as far as it goes, it just flips to zero.
Just for the kids.
That's a flip.
For the kids.
And back then, they didn't have the endings to the game. They just didn't in Atari. So that was the big deal, is to flip the game. So my brother had flipped Pac-Man. Damn. So for me to flip.
That's intense.
Asteroids was a big deal.
So did he then respect you after that?
I don't think so. Because to them, video games wasn't that big a deal.
Yeah.
But to me, it just consumed me. Yeah. I couldn't stop. I remember not having a Nintendo at the time when I was younger, and paying a friend a quarter so I could play pro wrestling on a Nintendo. Such a great game. I would say out of all the NES games, probably Super NES games, that pro wrestling for the NES was the best wrestling game that came out. I mean,
you have to go back and play it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I got
Who's your guy?
I don't know. I haven't played it. I don't think.
You have a guy?
Who? So there's so many wrestling games, but like who are the characters?
Amazon and Starman.
And like, right?
Yes. They do the Enziguri, which is Inoki, and like they played off a lot of some of the Japanese stuff because, of course, probably made in Japan.
Yeah.
So, but I don't. For some reason, I always like Amazon. Who cares? Like hit him with the dunks, and then like no, I don't know. Grind his teeth on their head. No, it was like the best thing ever. Yeah. Like it was such a great game.
That was a really good game. I think Starman was my guy.
Yeah, it was everybody's, right? And I just remember going, that's the stupidest thing I've ever seen. Nobody can do a drop kick and land on their feet.
And look at you now.
Gotcha.
Well, I know it's not that hard.
But, well, for some, I'm not that agile.
The fact of the matter is, it was a great game, and it was before its time, and everything that it had in there. The thing was, you could never beat the game.
Yeah.
You just kind of keep going through it.
Defending. We might have a tournament.
It was a great game, fun game to play. And that's what it's all about.
Yeah.
Easy to play, hard to master. That's the ultimate. If you can get that in a game, you have the ultimate game.
Yeah. Guys, give a round of applause for the Prince of Phenomenal.
Golf up.
And thank you for the special appearance on the Save Point for Mr. 24/7. Check out Prince of Phenomenal on Twitter
at AJStylesORG.
Follow Mr. 24/7 on Twitter at
TrueKofi.
Follow your boy Austin Creed on Twitter at XavierWoodsPhD. Follow the channel on Instagram and Twitter at UpUpDownDown without the O's. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it tight.